Hello, and welcome to another video of Factorio. I am Deozon, and last video we had just got some robots set up for the first time, and now they're working away merrily, but the, basically all of the, to produce them we're using a lot more of these green circuits, we're using a lot more steel, so we've got a shortage of some things, so this time we're probably going to be spending a lot of it just trying to help fix the shortages so they're not so short anymore. We'll make them longages? I don't know. To deliver some more inserters to me. And actually, I could get them to build all this for me if I just expand the RoboPort over there. Why didn't I think of that before? Why am I doing work when my robots could be doing the work for me? I forgot the point of this game, which is automate all the things. So I need some more of these. Where are my logistics bots and why? Oh, they're not bringing me inserters because these are not provider chests. I think I'm going to set up automating the provider chests as well. So it needs a steel chest. Yeah. Well, I'll get to that eventually, but probably not now. Because I've got some robots to boss around. See, and so this is an example of my quote-unquote perfect grid being interrupted by building plans. Although, again, I said last time I don't necessarily care about the perfect grid so much as being efficient with my RoboPorts, but in retrospect, I kind of do care about the perfect grid. I kind of care about it a lot. Actually, if I make the RoboPorts in the provider chest, then the bots will build the RoboPorts too. I won't have to do anything ever again. These guys are going real slow because they've been away from the RoboPort for too long, so they're out of energy. They start moving slow. This is all in a construction area, so they're going to finish building that, which I don't necessarily want them to, but it won't hurt anything because it's not really going anywhere. And they will finish building this. Well, they would if they had... Did I not add splitters? And I did not. I just did the belts. This is just barely out of reach of the logistics. So I need another RoboPort over here somewhere. So I have this design that I like to use just to expand the RoboPort in a perfect grid because it's annoying having to place the RoboPort and then place the power line and then making sure the power line can stretch as far and then things like that. And it also adds extra things like storage chests near every RoboPort, some lights near every RoboPort, some power lines, and then it also makes it easy to figure out where the perfect grid is simply by lining up where this power line is. I line up the power line on the right with it, and I know that I've got it lined up properly, which is helpful when you're expanding these ghosts. They don't show, like that one's not showing the area, the logistics area. So if I'm trying to expand down this way, and that one wasn't there to connect this one, I would just link the power line, which is here and hard to see because it's dark and in the trees. But I would line up the power line so that it turns blue, and place it down like that. And then the robots will eventually, they'll build that one first, and then they'll build that one. But right now they can't do that because they're missing a lot of stuff. So it might be time to automate the production of electric power poles, so steel and copper. See, and they're already resupplying me with these belts that I'm using up. So nice of them. Alright, steel and copper. Want another one of those. This one will make medium electric poles. This one large electric poles or big electric poles. And then they will store them in provider chests. I guess I have to build a couple more myself. Stack of those. So now I should automate the lights too. Circuits, iron sticks, and iron. Do that here. Iron sticks and lights. Oh yeah, and probably, I don't remember how, I think they'll stack to 50. So, 25, I mean, 5 stacks. full stack, but I'll give it 2 just in case. Those will give it 4 stacks. Okay. It's important to remember to set limits on things. And then I was going to automate chests. So I need steel and circuits. Circuits and steel. I accidentally picked one up. That's another thing. If they get too close to you because they're bringing you stuff, you can accidentally pick them up, which is not great. Okay, why aren't they producing more of this? More of the copper. Because I need 48 more furnaces. And even if they did finish... Oh yeah, and that's not in the... logistics. Oh, wait. Yeah, it should be. They just are slow getting to it. And I was gonna move one over here. Okay, I need 72 furnaces. Where is all of the stuff? Stone. I don't have it in a chest anywhere. One of the annoyances with having auto trash is the rare time when you actually do want to use the stuff. Stuck in there, and then you can't really do anything with it. So 50, 60, 70. Okay, I have enough now. Alright, bots, do your work. I guess I'll do it. Might as well, since I'm here. Splitters get there, because that will make it so that it doesn't make it so that the materials don't properly stay on one side without having the other splitter there. So right now the bots seem really inefficient. It's because they are. I'll be able to research some things that will help them to move faster and carry more things at once, and a bunch of stuff like that. So they'll get better over time, but for now, and also I don't have very many of them. It's not uncommon to use hundreds. actually build these things like this, which will provide power. Steel and copper, that's kind of the issue I started this video saying was the problem. But now that I've got bots working on building all of this stuff, I can focus on actually getting the copper. Poor placement on my part. Is it important? It's not important that the copper comes down over here, so I'm just going to bring it down through here, I suppose. At least some of it. Have more than one line of copper on the bus. That should start helping out. Solar panels, sure, why not? And then this last one. Just send it straight down. Basically, we need to rebalance. Construction zone, so they're just being slow getting to it, but that should all work out. They've all got power. Okay, I forgot to put my bots that I grabbed onto the network, so that should help quite a bit. First of all, what is this? Oh, this used to be the plastic. Okay, well that's not needed anymore. So I can mark that for deconstruction, and the bots might get to it eventually. I also need more copper ore. connect up all these copper furnaces if they don't have the ore to supply them. That. Get it connected there. Why is it so dark? Oh, I don't have lights in my blueprints of this. Bring me lights. And now that I'm consuming a lot more coal over here, how's this doing? It's doing fine. Well, not really, but it's doing fine for power. So now those RoboPorts, they will get put into a storage chest, and the next time the robots need to build a RoboPort, instead of grabbing it from here, because this is a passive provider chest, it's like grab from here kind of as a last resort. So it'll grab from here first. So anything that's in storage will be used before anything in a passive provider chest, generally speaking. How's our copper doing? Still not great. I think I'm going to add a 4-belt balancer here, just so they can all start off kind of on the same foot. I'm pretty sure we need those to be there. You know, it doesn't really make sense to balance it and then split off immediately after. I think I'll move this here. Well, I mean, it kind of makes sense. I think what I'll just do is have that split off there and make sure everything is feeding into it, so the bottom belt will be as full as possible, because we need lots of copper. And in fact, I think I intended this line to be another copper line. Here on out. Well, until we start messing with it again. But basically, yeah, we need a lot more. Oh yeah, that's what I was gonna do. Going to add these miners to the network, and they're not in the network. Want to be in the network, I need to have that RoboPort right in the middle of everything. Where does it have to go? Just down one. Alright. Like I said, I prefer it to be in a perfect grid, but it doesn't have to be a perfect grid. So, for this, just put it right there. So now the miners are in that, the logistics area. The engines are in the logistics area. Good. I can put these in the logistics area. The robots. Yeah. these things being produced, the chests will be ready. Okay. Somewhere I generally have a chest full of green circuits and red circuits, but I don't think I did that anywhere. The copper production is still not great. Not great at all. Steel production's not too great either. Oh right, the copper production's not great because I was going to add more miners. I generally like to have them aligned, but, well, sure, why not? Mostly because I space the power lines apart in such a way that each power line can power three of them. Those three, which makes me think I want to move that there. If I place a miner here, then it will mine both the copper and the coal, so I don't really want to deal with that at the moment, so I'm not going to put one there. But how am I doing as far as... So most of that's outside of the construction zone. And let's get some lights in here, because I can't see anything. this needs to... Well, I don't know if it needs it, but... having the red belts here will make sure the ore goes faster through here so these ones can keep working. And this one's pretty long, so it may have similar problems. Once all the miners get put up anyway. Okay, I lost track of time, and it has been way too long. So, it's time to end this video. So, I hope you found this amusing, entertaining, even if it was a little, I don't know, distracted or meandering at times. But it looks like we finally did solve the copper problem. The steel production could still use some work, but that will have to wait for another time. So, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.